This is The Hive. It's open 8 till 5, Monday till Friday, and we serve coffees, smoothies, paninis, and baguettes, but no alcohol. And we're going to show you now how to make a smoothie. When a customer orders a smoothie, make sure you check the number and the ingredients that go into it. Each smoothie box is labelled by number in the freezer. Select the one you need. Double check any extra ingredients. Each smoothie takes between 4 and 5 apples, depending on how juicy they are. Slice your apples into quarters and make sure you mind your fingers on the knife. Add any extra ingredients you might need. Place your jug under the apple juicer, switch it on, and insert between 2 and 4 apples at a time. When the level reaches between 60 and 70 on the jug, switch the juicer off, and make sure you place the drip cup underneath to catch any spillage. Place a lid securely onto the jug and the jug onto the blender. Close the lid of the blender and press the number 5. While the smoothie is juicing, you can always take payment from the customer to save time. Place your lid firmly onto the cup. And pour in your smoothie. Pop in a straw and it's ready to serve. Always make sure to rinse your jug and your lid. And to clean up any mess you might have made. And that's how you make smoothies. When making a frappe, scoop between 4 and 5 cubes of ice into your jug. And fill with milk to between the 300 and 400 mark of the jug. Select the flavour the customer asked for and use 1 scoop of the powder. Make sure you put the lid on securely. Place the jug onto the blender and press the pulse button, holding your finger down until you can no longer hear the cubes of ice. Pour the frappe into the cup. Place in a straw and it is ready to serve to the customer. Always make sure to rinse your jug and lid after use. And replace the jug into the bucket, stacking them correctly. When serving an Americano, dispose of the used grounds in the drawer and dispense 2 shots of fresh coffee. Tamp the coffee grounds and return to the coffee machine. All our coffees are served as a double shot as standard. When topping up with hot water, make sure to use the water boiler. When serving a cappuccino, dispense a double shot of coffee into the cup. You will need slightly less milk than you will use for a latte. Heat the milk on the steamer, keeping the steamer close to the top of the milk so as to froth it. Always make sure to clean the steamer with the red cloths after every use. Fill the cup to 2/3 with hot milk. And the rest with the frothed milk. Sprinkle on some chocolate powder and serve on a saucer. This is a great shot. When making a cup of tea, make sure not to use the hot water top up on the coffee machine, but use the hot water machine located at the end of the bar. Fill the cup with hot water and serve to the customer.
To make a latte, you will need enough milk to fill a cup. Empty the grounds and it's two shots as standard. When steaming, you want to keep the steam wand just below the surface and then sink it down as the milk heats up to get rid of any heavy foam and get the milk circulating. You don't want heavy foam like you would on a cappuccino. Milk that's been steamed properly should not have any large bubbles. Knocking it on the table gets rid of these and swirling it around makes it smooth and glossy. You should always be able to see your reflection in it. For the final pour, you want to aim right at the center and pour slowly and confidently so that the espresso rises with the milk. And that's it.